India's top business leaders have gathered in Davos for the World Economic Forum. Wion's business correspondent caught up with Pawan Goenka, the managing director of Mahindra and Mahindra Limited. Listen in to this exclusive conversation.
We're joined by Pawan Goenka, MD of Mahindra and Mahindra, a company which has already become global from India. So first of all, thanks for joining us here at Davos.
My pleasure.
Global trade wars have engulfed the global economy. What do you think, what India's role here, how India stands to gain?
Well, I see an opportunity for India. Okay, there is a lot that's happening. The US-China tension that we see. Can India occupy a space that may be vacated by some other exporting countries? Okay, now, one would say, okay, that's fine. It's easy for Dr. Goenka to stand here and say that. How do we do it? It's not going to be easy, but we have to take many baby steps, and we need to take some major steps. And I guess one of the biggest thing there would be that rather than going to rule-based agreements, can we get to deal-based agreements? That means have more bilaterals, talk to the countries where there's a good export-import potential that we have. If you look at South Asia, for example, the trade in South Asia, within the country of South Asia, is so small compared to GDP, compared to the population. What can we do? How can India become the leader in it? Can India say that, look, we are the bigger economy in South Asia. We are going to give little more than we take, but let's increase trade in the South Asian countries. So I think India can play a leadership role in perhaps occupying a step that may be vacated by some other countries.
Sir, 6-7% growth in GDP. Going forward, do you think we can be better? And even if not better, to sustain that, what steps are required?
Well, I think we can be better. I'm being a bit optimistic, but I'm not alone. There are many who think that Indian economy can do very well. There are a lot of things that have not worked well. And yet we have grown at 7% plus. If all of those things worked well, we certainly should be touching 9-10% kind of growth. So I think that's doable. Again, it won't happen by itself. The government, the industry, the civil society have to work together to make it happen. And I think industry in some sense has a bigger role to play in that than what they've been doing. In terms of how do we create our goods and services to be amongst the most desired globally, okay? Create a pull for our goods and services and not simply try and compete on cost.
And you're a company which is global to some extent and trying to actually become more global, which is in many countries. What problems are you facing and what do you think are the challenges, main challenges as an Indian company you face and how to overcome that?
Well, there are three. There are three that come to my mind immediately. The number one is brand. So Indian brand as a manufacturing brand is not a brand that has much of a strength outside India. And a brand of an Indian company will kind of get associated with the Indian brand. So you cannot build a Mahindra brand without having an India brand. So that's number one. Number two, the protectionism that we see today, almost all the markets that we're going to, each government is looking to see how do we invest locally, how do we set up a plant locally. And it's not possible to do that in every country because the investment required will not be justified. And third one is scale. In many cases, to be globally competitive, we have to have a larger scale than many Indian companies have, than what Mahindra has in the sort of automotive industry. The size that we have is very small compared to giants in the industry. And therefore, how do we overcome the sort of disadvantage of a scale? So if we can do brand, the protectionism issue, and the scale, then I think we can do very well.
So last two quick questions. Back home, we are all awaiting for the budget Feb 1. Do you think it'll be a big bank budget, some big announcements will be there, or do you think it'll be kind of budget which generally happens in election year?
I think it would be somewhere in the middle, closer to what happens in election year than a big bank budget. Maybe there'll be few announcements that will happen because we're still perhaps about 3 months away from election. So there could be few announcements that will happen, which will be sort of a populist announcement. But more or less, I think it will remain as an interim budget.